Good morning, YouTube. It is finally peak week. It's so crazy to say that I literally have about 5 days left of this challenge. Today is the start of my carb depletion, so I've been eating around 200 grams of carbs. Today I'm gonna be eating around 130, and slowly gonna drop it to pretty much just trace carbs. So around like 30 to 40 grams of carbs, but we're slowly gonna drop that down. I have a pretty busy day today, so I just got to the gym. Have a nice shoulder and chest day. So we're gonna go in here, bang that out, get that finished with, and then like I said, I got a couple more things I gotta do for the rest of the day. But yeah, let's head in the gym and get this workout started.
All right, we're starting the day off with some side laterals. You know, as I'm going into this peak week, first of all, I know I've gotten a lot leaner, but I don't think I'm like already lean, just because this was an 8 week challenge. It was just to try to get as shredded as possible. But I definitely think that I could have gotten a little bit leaner if I had more time. That's besides the point. I'm still gonna do a typical peak week, and I'm not 100% sure if this is the best way for me to approach peak week, because it's the first time I've ever done it before. My plan was 4 days of carb depletion, 2 days of carb loading, managing water and sodium a little bit as well. Not crazy, but paying attention to either high consumption of water and sodium or low consumption of water and sodium. So I did a lot of research online, and I think I found what's gonna work best for me. I'm not saying that this is the perfect way to do it or anything like that, but there may be better ways of going about it, but I did a lot of research and I think this is the most effective way that I can do it personally. I will say, tomorrow's my last leg day, and I'm glad that it's more towards the beginning of the carb depletion and not at the end, because that would definitely be a very tough workout. All these workouts this week are gonna be pretty tough. Definitely glad the leg day is tomorrow, so. Surprisingly, this is the first time I've done seated shoulder press this whole entire challenge. I don't know why. It's one of my favorite ways to hit shoulders, so probably get to do it today. This is the last weekend that I will be on my diet, which feels so good to say that next weekend I can finally eat some good food. Before I was doing this challenge, I was easily able to rep 85, 90s. I got 80s today for a set of 10. Super, super low on energy. I don't even know how this is gonna move. I'm hoping it moves good. Oh, I just squeezed out a fart. That was nice. We're gonna see how these 80s move. Let's see what we got, man. I got 9. That's still pretty good for how low I am on energy. So like I said earlier, I'm doing some typical peak week stuff, so I gotta shave my legs, which that'll be interesting. I'm not gonna get a tan. I'm not stepping on stage, but I'd like to get as much of a natural tan as I can. But who knows, might not be able to get much sun because of this hurricane over here on the West Coast, which will kind of suck, but hey man, it's part of life. Next week I'll be finished with the challenge, so I'm gonna put out a whole video of me just explaining my thoughts on the challenge, how I think I did, and a whole bunch of stuff. Plans on future diet. I still have a lot of questions for myself as for what I want to do, but for the most part, I have a general idea of what I'm gonna say. So, oh, I'm also gonna get a haircut because this is just not gonna cut it. No pun intended. I mean, this is brutal. I think once I get a haircut, it will help my face look slimmer. It'll kind of bring my whole physique together, so. Getting a haircut on Tuesday. Yeah. That was a grind of a rep. That's the type of effort it's gonna take to win the challenge. I don't record every set and everything I do in the gym, but that's how a lot of this challenge has gone, grind reps like that. Whether you're bulking, cutting, doesn't matter. You should be pushing relatively close to failure, if not to failure. Those grind reps like that are what help you kind of push over. That's what kind of separates you as far as, you know, if you just want to look decent and have a decent physique and all this, you don't have to go that hard in the gym, but if you want to really push the boundaries, you got to make sure you're getting legs, chest, back, whatever muscle group, you got to make sure you're getting some reps in like that. All right, moving on to some seated shoulder press. The aid in stability here is going to help me go to produce a little bit more force. That's why. Slightly different than a dumbbell variation. Most of you probably don't know either. I'm a college student, so I start class on Monday, which I would really like to skip. Not because I just want to skip class, but just because I want to like finish this challenge. And like that's all I want to think about this next week. But I have to go to class. It's not gonna be too bad. It'd be during a time where I eat lunch, chill out anyways, so it's not too big of a deal. But I wish I could just focus on this challenge and not have to deal with going to school. But I'm going into my final semester at Arizona State, getting a degree in exercise science. So ready to be finished with that. Yeah, excited to graduate in December and finally be finished with school. Here we go with another exercise that I don't think I have had to do at all in this program. I must be coming around to like a new block or something. This isn't one of my favorite ways to hit lateral raises, but it's what we got on the agenda today. So got a couple more shoulder exercises and then we'll be wrapping up the workout with some chest. I don't know if I'm tripping with saying this. I wouldn't say a lot, but I have seen some fitness influencers that have. The big one is like vaping addictions. In my opinion, I don't think that you should be giving advice to people if you're struggling with an addiction. And I get it, everybody goes through struggles in life. I'm not perfect, I have my own issues, but I'm not coming on here telling people that, oh, fitness is this easy, it's this easy to get your protein in, it's this easy to do all these workouts, like all this information's online, and then going and vaping and doing stuff that I know is bad for me. And being like, oh, I just keep going back to vaping, I don't know what it is. Like, it's just like so contradictory. You're trying to tell people to be healthy and then you're like saying, oh, I can't deal with this vape addiction, or I don't know, maybe I'm fucked for saying that, but if you're struggling with any sort of addiction, I don't know, I just feel like you shouldn't be giving people fitness advice. And like I said, I get everybody has their struggles and nobody's perfect, but me personally, at my current point in life, I have zero bad addiction, in my opinion. I have a job, I go to school, make fitness TikToks, I'm in shape, I eat healthy, like I don't smoke, I don't drink. I'm not saying you can't do those things, but when you have an addiction tied to it, maybe I'm tripping, but.
I do want to be on the TV show. I'm dying to be on the TikTok. On the TikTok.
Step that way. You're gonna be on YouTube, not TikTok.
Oh, YouTube.
Oh, wow. Make sure you get your moms in the gym.
Moms in the gym.
All moms need to be in the gym.
That way we can live forever.
Hopefully. Fitness crave is kind of a thing right now. As social media has kind of pushed more exercise, so make sure you're getting your family in the gym. You should be encouraging others. Just because you're healthy and your family has grown up unhealthy and, you know, doesn't mean they need to stay like that. As much as you want to see yourself do really good and you want to see yourself succeed and you want to be healthy, what's life if you don't have people around you? Friends, family, you know, so. Whether your parents are going to the gym or they're just going outside to exercise for the day or whatever. You know, they don't have to lift crazy heavy. My parents don't lift crazy heavy weight, but they exercise. So get your family in the gym. All right, I'm finishing with some chest flies right now. This will be the end of the workout portion. I got a little surprise after this. Stay tuned for next Sunday for the final results. I'll have my before and afters so you can really see how much progress I made, because it's crazy when you look at it. When you look at my before pictures, it's actually insane how much I've changed. I'm down around 20 pounds right now. A little bit of muscle, mainly fat. Stay tuned for next week, and I'll see you guys for that little surprise I have. If you're not already following my TikTok, Instagram, or subscribe to my YouTube, make sure to follow, stick along for the journey. This is only the beginning, man. This is only the beginning, so stay tuned for that little surprise. But otherwise, I'll see you guys next Sunday. Thanks so much for watching. All right, it's pretty late at night, and I almost forgot to show you guys the surprise that I had. We got these delicious snacks. Cheat day coming very, very soon. Thanks so much for watching.